here I have our hierarchical data viewer in local mode. You remember we deployed it as well to Streamlit Cloud, and we had to add a form to connect to any Snowflake account. If we deploy this into a Snowflake as a Streamlit app, we don't need any such form. It will be automatically connected to that specific account. Let's just have a look at what we have here. We have the source file, Yeah, definitely right now it's a CSV file, but we can specify a table view. Path. The path will be populated only for a table view. Formats with different formats here. The graph, GraphViz, and Visualize Online, this button. Different charts with plot line and animated charts with these three. I just show you this because you'll see there are already some limitations in Streamlit when it's hosted by Snowflake. You can see here a limitation, not supported features. It's because for now it is in public preview, but some of them could remain here because there could be considered a threat. You can see here components, HTML is not supported. So this means that any D3 animations that we implemented with this way will not be supported. Okay, so back to our project. I'll simply interrupt for now our web server, and I'll go here into tab animation, and I'll do this. You know, I'll put into a try except block all the animation. If this fails, I will send a warning, not supported, and you see the import animated module will be also in this block. What else? You'll see that the Streamlit version currently deployed there, that's an older version, does not support yet link button. So I'll do the same try, except I'll quietly ignore this. It's not so important. But what I added here right now, I added also an Streamlit app function that returns the status of get active session. Get active session comes from the context of Snowpark. So this get active session, as you see here, is called first get Streamlit app session. Yeah? If the session is none, we continue with the rest. And let's see what else do we have here. Yeah, definitely I will send a warning. I already did this, if not selected. I will keep the file uploader only for local files. And yeah, no, generally this should do it. Let's move to something else. When you have dependencies, you have to pass everything in environment YAML. Not in requirements text. Why is this? Because Streamlit apps, they use conda. Under dependencies, I put plotly, and yes, this will not work. Anyway, we have to exclude whatever this reanimation we added. Going now to the deploy script, yeah, just to automate the process. You see, I try to use variable substitution from SnowSQL. With variable substitution true, you can define a variable, a script variable, yeah, that's specific to SnowSQL. Why is this? Because I have a common portion for each file that I will upload with put, and I don't want to repeat it again and again. So that's the way you use it. And I will transfer several files this time, not just app.py. I will transfer anything from modules. I will transfer anything from data. And yeah, we just said that animated templates, animated charts will not work. So I will exclude this. And yeah, you see here environment YAML, which will be executed. And data viewer Snowflake would be the name of our Streamlit object. that I will load also under test public through the Streamlit stage, recreated only if it does not exist. So if I go here and I run it, NoSQL dash C demo connection, yeah, that's our connection, dash F deploy SQL. Okay. Let's look for any text in red, nothing. So we had no errors. And yeah, you can see here data viewer Snowflake creating among the listed Streamlits. Going back to our account. Yeah, I can find it here. Let's refresh it just in case. That's the one. Okay, so let's see. Right now I'm with an internal CSV file. This looks good. Yeah, animated. Yeah, not supported. And you can see here the graph, I don't have a link. Okay, so if I say tests public, and I will call the AMP depth view. Yeah, that's a view that we have. Yeah, everything changed. I have a pass this time, populated. Okay, the graph changed. Chart, and yeah, that's as usual, this is not supported. Let's have a look at edit. I can edit for now only the top application file, as you can see, but I cannot edit other files. Yeah, this is a bit weird, but it is what it is. If you look into packages, yeah, of course, I can see Plotly, the latest version. That's why I can show charts. And Plotly is part of Anaconda packages because you have...